Almost a year ago, Amazon announced that it was searching for a location for its second headquarters. As part of HQ2, Amazon would hire 50,000 full-time employees and invest $5 billion on new construction, a project that would be valuable for any city. Amazon took the unusual step of prompting cities all across North America to pitch themselves to the company, laying out exactly what they can offer to the tech giant. In its request for proposals, Amazon described what kind of place it was looking for: a large city with a business-friendly environment, close to an international airport, access to mass transit, and of course, tax breaks. Lots of tax breaks. Knowing that some cities might be prevented by law from giving a large tax break to Amazon, the company helpfully states on its request that it's willing to allow cities to create special legislation just to offer Amazon a more lucrative deal. This very public search was clearly meant to start a bidding war among cities, with cities vying to offer more and more generous tax breaks in the hopes of luring Amazon. And on this count, it's very much succeeded. 238 cities submitted proposals. While most of those bids have been kept private, the numbers that have leaked out to the public are huge. Atlanta offered Amazon $1 billion in reduced taxes. Chicago, $2 billion. Newark, $7 billion. Maryland, $8.5 billion. Dallas's mayor announced, quote, "We're not going to be outbid on Amazon doing business here," end quote. Amazon will announce the winner of this search sometime later in 2018. Although Amazon's approach to finding the location for HQ2 might seem unprecedented, no part of it's new. Certainly, governments have been giving tax breaks to companies to move and invest there for literally centuries. The first place-based tax incentive in the U.S. came when New Jersey tried to lure Alexander Hamilton's manufacturing organization into the state. The first ever recorded tax incentive was given in 1160 in Italy when a city-state bid for a textile-producing facility. It's also not new for a company to publicly pit governments against themselves in a bidding war. Take GM, for example. When GM, in 1985, was considering where in the U.S. to place its Saturn production plant, it launched a public bidding war by having GM's chairman, Roger Smith, hold a press conference announcing the search. 30 states eventually submitted packages of tax breaks, credits, and exemptions. No, Amazon's brazen attempt to launch a bidding war over HQ2 isn't new, but that doesn't mean it isn't powerful for the company. By launching such a public campaign, Amazon has gotten cities all over the U.S., including cities that Amazon likely never even considered, to pitch themselves to the company. This is important because it allows Amazon to construct a list of which tax breaks are possible throughout the U.S. And remember, it's not just the size of the tax breaks that matter. Cities have been encouraged to think creatively about what kind of giveaways it can offer the company. Giveaways that would be valuable to the company, but not costly for the city, including renaming sections of the city itself after Amazon. This trove of information on what tax breaks are possible can then be used in two ways. First, it can help pressure other cities into upping their bid because Amazon can hint vaguely at another city's better offer. Second, Amazon can use this information in the future when deciding where to place its warehouses, tech offices, and fulfillment centers, knowing exactly which areas are desperate for jobs and investment, and so are willing to offer large concessions. Okay, now, there's a few things to keep in mind when thinking about HQ2. Probably the most important point to remember is that the money given away as tax incentive to a company is not free. That money is being diverted from someplace else. Perhaps the money had helped to fund schools, run social programs, or build roads and public transit systems. Regardless, the money given away to a company like Amazon has an opportunity cost and could be funding other productive public services. True, if the tax incentive secures Amazon's second headquarters, then that money could potentially bring in additional jobs and tax revenue, and so lessen the cost of the tax incentive. But then again, better funding schools, job training programs, and transportation could make the city more attractive to businesses, and so spur the local economy as well. The next two points to keep in mind come from economics research. There's a large body of research that shows that tax incentives are both less powerful and more wasteful than you'd think. less powerful because companies have more important priorities than the size of short-term tax breaks offered. Priorities like the resources available and the quality of the workforce. More wasteful because the majority of tax incentive dollars go to companies that would have invested in the city even without the tax break. And even when the tax incentive was critical to luring the company to invest in that location, it's frequently the case that the cost of the tax incentive given exceeds the benefit of the company's investment. This is known as the winner's curse. Knowing all of this, how should cities respond to Amazon's HQ2 request for proposals? One thing cities could do is to devote the money it would have given as a tax break to the company to improving the city's public infrastructure. That would mean that the dollars spent would be useful to all companies in the city and not just one. Cities should also keep in mind that while Amazon is certainly big, it's not unique in being able to bring in jobs and investment. Because of this, cities should publicly announce what deals are on offer, specifying that if another company can bring in a percent of what Amazon promises, then the city will give them something like a percent of the tax incentive it offered to Amazon. And here's the twist. The tax incentive is only open on a first-come, first-served basis, meaning that when the tax incentive money has been exhausted, the offer is closed. This modification could turn the type of competition on its head, converting a situation in which the governments are stuck in a hyper-competitive race-to-the-bottom situation to one in which the companies are competing over the cities. Thanks for watching.